dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky. This is WYMT Mountain News at 11.
Good evening, I'm Steve Hensley. A Kentucky State Police training presentation is drawing heavy criticism because of its content. Adolf Hitler is quoted three times in some of the slides. The presentation was released today by student journalists at the Manual Red Eye, a Louisville high school publication. A Louisville lawyer sent the materials to them after getting them through an open records request. Shelby Lofton has reaction from two men concerned with the message behind the words.
The 33-page slideshow titled The Warrior Mindset outlines the ethics, values, beliefs, and role of those in the Kentucky State Police Academy. Quotes from Adolf Hitler appear throughout the course with links to his work and biography.
To train police with the image of Hitler to be killers, to be warriors, is a phenomenal error in judgment.
Confederate General Robert E. Lee is also included. Recruits are instructed to be, quote, ruthless killers, meeting violence with greater violence. Rabbi Shlomo Litvin clicked through the presentation just before the Sabbath. He said, it's now time to right this wrong.
They need to attend a class, they need to attend some sort of course, to learn what was wrong with this, how this got anyone's approval.
Criminal defense attorney Daniel Whitley said this material makes him question KSP's actions.
The Kentucky State Police and do a lot of an investigation on our local police officers to hold them accountable. And if their mentality is that Adolf Hitler is a person they look up to go through our community and police, you know, our whole community should be shocked by this.
He said in a year when several Kentuckians were killed by state police and in the midst of the aftermath of Breonna Taylor's death, he's asking if the agency is credible.
Are they there to really serve and protect, or are they just reckless cowboys with a hidden agenda?
Kentucky State Police said the material is unacceptable and that it was removed in 2013. Whitley said that's not enough.
And anyone who ever was a part of this, participated in this, should be immediately fired.
Governor Andy Beshear said his administration is collecting more information and plans to take action. Both Rabbi Litvin and Whitley said this doesn't change their perception of every member of law enforcement.
To me, this doesn't show poorly on the officers of the Kentucky State Police, but rather on the leadership.
I work with and been around a lot of great officers who wear that uniform with pride. But when these incidents like this occur, it makes and it tarnishes their character.
In Lexington, Shelby Lofton, WKYT.
The Kentucky chapter of the ACLU called for any cadet given this presentation be retrained. The executive director said training should be focused on conflict resolution rather than use of force. One person is dead after a crash in Pike County. It happened on U.S. 23 in the Virgie community this afternoon. Troopers say 69-year-old Loretta Kaiser was driving in the northbound lanes of U.S. 23 when she tried to turn onto Caney Drive. While crossing the southbound lanes, 49-year-old David Collins hit Kaiser's car. Kaiser was pronounced dead at the scene. This was the worst week ever for COVID-19 cases in the United States. And here in Kentucky, Governor Andy Beshear announced 1,941 new cases today. The statewide total increased to 105,242. There were 15 new deaths today, bringing the death toll to 1,476. Tonight, we also learned of the first two COVID-19-related deaths in Breathitt County. The positivity rate is 6.19%, and at least 18,407 people have recovered from the virus. For more on COVID-19 in Kentucky, you can go to our website at WYMT.com. As businesses continue to take a hit because of the pandemic, many continue to find ways to survive. Jayco, a transportation service company in London, has sedans, limousines, vans, and motor coaches. At the start of the pandemic, they were forced to essentially lay off their employees, but since April, they have seen an uptick in business, hiring back their employees and even adding some new staff.
We've been able to rebound pretty well on sedan, SUV, van, limousine. Trips, buses have been very slow to come back, and then motor coaches have been really non-existent.
Lopez says they continue to provide their services for events like weddings, but are just seeing them on a smaller scale. Heading into the final weekend before Election Day, the presidential candidates focused on rallying voters in the Midwest. President Trump held events in Michigan, Minnesota, and Wisconsin. Former Vice President Joe Biden made stops in Wisconsin, Iowa, and Minnesota. CBS's Skylar Henry reports from the White House.
President Trump and Joe Biden attacked each other once again over the coronavirus pandemic.
Biden wants to keep everyone locked up.
I'm not going to shut down the economy. I'm going to shut down the virus.
As new cases rise in nearly every state, the president promised a vaccine in a matter of weeks. But his rally in Green Bay, Wisconsin was under fire before it even started. As the local hospital system warned, it was a bad idea. The city has one of the highest infection rates in the country. At a drive-in rally in Des Moines, Iowa, the former vice president vowed to restore unity to the nation.
Honk if you want America to be united again. We cannot afford four more years of Donald Trump.
The president tried to present his Democratic challenger as lax on law and order.
And during one of the debates, I said, hey, Joe, say the words law and order. Can you do it? He wouldn't do it because he didn't want to lose the radical left.
Early voting is continuing across the U.S. with more than 83 million ballots already cast. More than 9 million Texans voted early, surpassing the state's total vote from the 2016 presidential election.
We have the opportunity to change how things are going in our country with our vote. I think that's a big thing for me and a big thing for my friends as well.
And early voting operations around Los Angeles expanded to include sports venues like Dodger Stadium. Skylar Henry, CBS News, the White House.
In Minnesota, President Trump addressed a considerably smaller crowd tonight. The state capped the number of attendees to prevent further spread of the virus. Businesses and organizations in Harlan County received loans and grants today. JRL Coal received a business and industry guaranteed loan, which helps the company continue during the pandemic and keep more than 100 workers employed. The city of Everett's received a $50,000 grant to buy the police department two new trucks. And Community Action Kentucky, Inc. received more than $100,000 in grant money to help serve its communities. Eastern Kentucky native Rebecca Freeman Adcock tells us she is excited about today's news.
We wanted to be a part of lifting them up and supporting them, and are so proud to be here to be able to do that, and to do that in a way that is such a good use of tax dollars.
Officials and business leaders say they are looking forward to the positive economic impacts their investment will make.
It is cold out there. Temperatures already dropping into the upper 30s to lower 40s, and they'll continue to drop heading into tonight. Remember, we have that frost advisory until 10 a.m. on your Saturday, as we're going to see near freezing temperatures. We're going to get back to the upper 50s, though, Saturday, mid-50s Sunday. We see that high early in the day. Temperatures drop throughout the day, possibly some stray rain chances and some of those clouds. As we look into future view, temperatures looking to drop closer to about those mid-30s tonight. Not all of us getting near freezing, but some of us might get close to freezing. Temperatures warm back up with plenty of sunshine throughout the day Saturday. Clouds increase ahead of our next system, though, Sunday. There's those high temperatures early in the morning. Cold front moves in. Future view has a lot of rain. Not sure we'll see a lot of rain early Sunday, but definitely a trend to keep an eye on. Temperatures plummet after that. You can see already dropping into the 30s by 7 o'clock Sunday. We're expected to drop into about those upper 20s to lower 30s Sunday night into Monday, which is why we have a freeze watch out for the majority of our area. Once again, that's overnight Sunday into your Monday. Looking at the rest of the extended forecast, don't forget to set those clocks back an hour before you go to bed tomorrow as we get an extra hour of sleep. We have plenty of sunshine in store heading into next week. We'll see temperatures start to get a little bit on that warmer side starting on Election Day and continuing heading throughout the rest of the week.
Paige, thank you very much, and thank you for joining us tonight. But don't go anywhere. The Appalachian Wireless Sports Overtime is coming up next. Have a great weekend and happy Halloween.
Sky Alert Weather, sponsored by Community Trust Bank. Building communities built on trust.
The WYMT News app offers alerts on breaking stories as they happen, customized to the categories you choose. The WYMT News app, powered by Appalachian Wireless.
Liberal Amy McGrath opposes President Trump's border wall.
I think the wall is stupid.
But McGrath did support the Pelosi plan that would have given $1,200 taxpayer-funded checks to illegal immigrants and more money to Puerto Rico than Kentucky.
I am further left. Kentuckians. I am more progressive than anybody in the state of Kentucky.
Amy McGrath is too liberal for Kentucky. Keep Kentucky Great is responsible for the content of this advertising.
Why on earth is Mitch McConnell making false attacks against Brad Barron? After 36 years in Washington, McConnell's scared to be running against a true Kentucky conservative. Brad Barron is a farmer and a businessman, not a career politician. We can trust him to slash government waste and balance the budget. And Barron is 100% pro-Second Amendment, 100% pro-life, and yes, 100% pro-term limits. Vote for the true conservative, Brad Barron, for U.S. Senate. True Kentucky Patriots is responsible for the content of this advertising.
Meet liberal Chris Harris. Harris voted against the unborn, has an F rating from the NRA, and voted against protecting our police. And politician Chris Harris has never been a judge. Zero experience on the bench. Liberal Chris Harris, wrong for the Kentucky Supreme Court. But we have Judge Bob Conley, supported by the NRA and Kentucky Right to Life. Judge Conley will uphold law and order. 25 years experience. Judge Bob Conley for the Kentucky Supreme Court.
You've seen how my opponent treats people. His contempt for ordinary people is real. And the corporate special interests backing his campaign have an agenda that doesn't include you or me. For the last 25 years, I've been fighting for justice in courtrooms all across Kentucky, just like this one, including the Supreme Court. I'll treat people with dignity and respect. I'll apply the law fairly and defend our Constitution.
Welcome into the Appalachian Wireless Sports Overtime Show. I'm Willie Hope, up here by myself, but we have had a great night of football. Excited to bring these highlights to you. A lot of teams testing themselves before the playoffs in a couple weeks. Some great matchups tonight. Let's get right to it. We start in Johnson County, JC, hosting Belfry Golden Eagles. Hold the ball for 7 minutes on the first drive, and then after the score, force a fumble on the kickoff. So Pirates down 14-0 with their first look, less than 4 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Haywood's bunch gets the fourth down and two, then early second. Isaac Dixon cashes in. Look at this run. Stays on his feet somehow for the touchdown. Belfry up 14-7. Second half, same score. Pirates with the momentum, but they put it on the ground again. JC taking over. How will the offense respond to being punched in the mouth? Dylan Preston, who breaks the 1,000-yard rushing barrier, scores three TDs, make it 21-7. Dixon comes right back. First play of the drive. Look out. He is gone, folks. Marching to the end zone. That is your defending Class 3A state MVP. He is good, 21-14. Grant Rice goes, you like first plays? I saw you, I heard you, I raised you. The QB goes scampering down the sidelines. He gets down, gonna get all the way down. Looks like he's gonna score, but he'll get stopped at the 2-yard line. Don't worry, he's gonna finish his meal here, punching it in from 2 yards out. Johnson Central answers the bell, staying undefeated. They would take on one more, 35-14, the final, as the Pirates get shut out in the second half. WYMT's Tommy Poole was in attendance. He has more on this one. Tommy?
Yeah, this one had it all, and it was as advertised as two heavyweights going at it blow after blow. Like I said, this game had a little bit of everything. It had your explosive scores. It had your methodical drives. It had your turnovers and teams and players stepping up when it mattered the most. And at the end of the day, it was Johnson Central coming out 35-14, a game that put Coach Jim Matney in a great mood, one that he really wanted to win here, not only for his football team, but also the past in the history of him and Belfry and Coach Philip Haywood.
I grew up there. I played there and I coached there. And I actually was one of the people that wanted Coach Haywood to come coach there. I was not sure how our younger players would respond because they really had not been in this situation before to where we were threatened.
With the playoffs right around the corner, Coach Matney said this game was exactly what the doctor ordered. He now knows what his team has, and he knows what they will do when they need to answer that bell, and it'll be exactly what they did tonight, standing up and getting the job done. They put a stop to Belfry. Belfry having less than 130 yards of total offense, while Johnson Central totaled over 300. Reporting in Paintsville, Tommy Poole, WYMT Mountain Sports.
Thanks, Tommy. We go from two state champs to another one. The Pikeville Panthers have taken on all comers this year, from 6A schools to defending state champs Belfry, you just saw there. Their journey has taken them back to Lexington for a date with the top team in Class 2A. They take on Doug Charles, the Pikeville homecoming king of 1978 and 1979, Pikeville grad, and he married a homecoming queen. He at LCA knows all about the tradition. Second quarter, 7-0 LCA, third and goal. Junievis rolls right, his pass tip, and Nate Collins gets the pick. Panthers are in business. Pikeville wasting no time. Isaac McNamee looks for the top target, Zach Lockhart, on the fade route. And look out, Lockhart is in the open field. He's gone on this one. Pitter-patter down the sideline, an 89-yard pitch and catch. His eighth TD against Lexington Schools. What a stat. 7-6, Eagles. LCA again, same play as before. Davis looking for a chance. McGaughey passes tip by McGaughey, but he stays with it. What a score right there. 14-6 LCA. They would tack on 21 more points in this one. 35-13 is the final. LCA handing Pikeville their second loss of the season. Now, for our Appalachian Wireless game of the week, Breathitt County traveling to take on Pike Central. Bobcats have owned the series in this one, 9-1. Hawks come out swinging, though. Keegan Bentley takes the handoff, finds some daylight, and he is gone, folks. 24-8 Hawks at this point. Breathitt County will cut that lead down to 4 at the half. Out of the half, here come the Bobcats. Jalen Turner hits Caden Bolin. He goes bowling off of some Hawks defenders into the end zone. 28-14, Breathitt County. Here they come. Pike Central would retake the lead. Bobcats respond again. Lane Weddle with a two-point conversion. So it's 34-30 Bobcats, but the Hawks would take the lead for good here. Matt Anderson with the TD. No surprise, he gets in the end zone like it is nothing. Then to seal it, Anderson again showing why he was our player of the week. Marching to the house to seal the deal. Hawks in the game on a 24-0 run. They hand Breathitt County their first loss of the season. 54-34, the final. We are off to a hot start tonight. So many good games tonight. Can't stress that enough, and we still have plenty more to go. When we come back, we take you out to Somerset for an Alice Lloyd College Mountain Top 10 matchup. Stay with us.
Want to know why Alice Lloyd College is a nationally ranked institution? Alice Lloyd College is one of the top colleges in America for graduating students with the least amount of debt, as approximately 98% of the students in graduate or professional school are working 10 months after graduation, is the only college in the nation that financially supports graduates, is one of the only 7 work colleges in the nation, and returns 83% of students back to the region. To find out more, go online or call today. Alice Lloyd College. Stay close, go far.
Johnny Ray Turner, an educator, coach, our state senator. He has worked with both parties to invest in public schools, protect our pensions, and fight for coal miners. His opponent has the same name but an extreme record. Johnny L. Turner would take health care away from Kentuckians, eliminate protections for pre-existing conditions, and even protect domestic abusers. On Tuesday, let's keep the right Johnny Turner in the Senate, Johnny Ray Turner.
Today's the day to get $1,250 customer cash off remaining new 2020 RAV4 hybrids and $2,000 off Highlander hybrids, or lease the all-new all-wheel drive Venza hybrid for $309 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
I'm a teacher, and I am voting Donald Trump for president. But in the state Senate race, I just can't vote for Johnny L. Turner. Our state senator, Johnny Ray Turner, has protected our health care and brought over $130 million to our district in the 2020 budget alone. As a retired coach and high school teacher, he supported all teachers by leading our march in Frankfort. He's a senator who can work with Hal Rogers and Governor Beshear. Vote Johnny Ray. I'm voting to stay with Johnny Ray.
Welcome back to our Appalachian Wireless Sports Overtime Show. Still some big-time matchups coming your way. We have a pair of Alice Lloyd College Mountain Top 10 matchups. Let's start with the defending Class 2A champs. Heading over to Somerset, defending state champs, like I said, hosting Corbin. playing without UK commit and starting quarterback Kaya Sharon. In the first, Cameron Combs hands it off to Blake Powers, 11 yards into the Briar jumper end zone. Redhounds up 7-0. Jumper's punt on the first drive, so Corbin gets the ball back, but the pressure leads to a fumble, and it's a purple jersey that recovers it. Somerset ball. Jumpers with a chance to get on the board. Josh Gross looks, fires, and he finds Gavin Stevens. He marches in the end zone. We're tied up at 7. But turnovers, the story of this game. And here's another block punt, loose ball, and sophomore Jared Smith is going to pick it up after the scramble, and he says, see you later. Peace out. I'm headed to the crib. 14-7, Somerset. But now we're tied up at 14 after a kickoff return TD. Here's where Somerset starts to fall apart. Combs finds a wide open Dylan Massengill. Game now 21-14. Just in case you haven't seen enough turnovers, here's another. Gross puts it on the turf. Freshman Franklin West for the Redhounds. That boy is gone. Redhounds now lead 28-14. Another field goal from the Redhounds, 31-14. Now, Cade Grundy at QB. Rolls, looking, fires. Seth Mills for the pick in the end zone. He eventually would trip, and that's the end of the first half. Corbin, all gas, no brakes in this one. The final, 48-21, handing Somerset back-to-back losses. Sports reporter Camille Gear was in attendance. She has more. Camille?
Well, Willie, for the second time this season, the Somerset Briar Jumpers on the losing end of things. Up 14-7 in the first half, the Corbin defense relentless against Kaya Sharon replacement Josh Gross. The Redhounds had 3 forced fumbles, with 1 being a scoop and score. Plus, not to mention 1 interception in the end zone to end the first half. Head coach Tom Greer says, although he's proud of the defensive effort, the offense really stepped it up too.
You know, we forced a couple turnovers. We have an interception. We forced a turnover and scoop and run it back for a touchdown. So our defense did a nice job. Which our offense, you know, Cameron Combs did a nice job throwing the football and threw a couple nice touchdowns for us. But, again, it's an overall team effort.
So as of right now, Somerset is off next week. Corbin, though, traveling to Whitley County to play there. So we will see maybe the last game of the regular season, but definitely into the playoffs, what the offense will look like once Kaya Sharon returns and is back in the mix. But for now, reporting in Somerset, Camille Gear, WYMT Mountain Sports.
Thanks, Camille. We head to our second Alice Lloyd College Mountain Top 10 matchup, a nail-biter, Letcher Central in Paintsville. Paintsville taking the early advantage. Luke Hyden punching it in from a yard out. Tigers go up 7-0. But here come the Cougars. Hayden Brashear getting the first down on this one, finding some room in the Tiger defense. Going to get up and flex those muscles a little bit. First down later on. Candidate for play of the year, Carson Adams rolls out. Throws a prayer. It's going to get tipped by a defender and somehow lands in the arms of Sam Little. Letcher Central will go on and to score to pull within 1-7-6. Start of the second half with some defense. Jonah Little forces the fumble, and Jackson Need recovers it. What a hit by the Cougars. That would lead to this. Adams taking it himself, breaking free for the end zone, giving the Cougars an 18-7 advantage. Look at him. Can't stop, won't stop into the end zone. One last effort for the Tigers. They're going to go for it on fourth and goal. They got to get some points here. And Nathan Marcellette comes up short. That would be the final nail in the coffin as Letcher Central holds on for an impressive win at home, 18-7. Close matchup in Whitesburg. The WYMT's Corey Sanding was at that game. He has more on this.
A chilly night here at Letcher Central quickly heated up for the hometown Cougars, particularly in the second half when they flexed their muscles on defense. Down 7-6 heading into the intermission, the Cougars came out of the locker room swinging, scoring 2 quick touchdowns while shutting Paintsville out in the second half, including a goal line stand to seal the deal. Given the short week of preparation, Cougars coach Junior Matthews says this can only benefit them. God willing, they get to keep on playing.
Well, God willing, you know, we'll continue to play, and every day's a gift. You know, every day that we get to practice, every day that we get to play is a gift, and we take it a day at a time and a week at a time. You know, we don't try to look too far ahead. So I'll just be thankful if we get to play next week.
When I asked Matthews about his team's defense, he could describe it using one word: elite. And we all know defense wins championships. In Whitesburg, Corey Sanding, WYMT Mountain Sports.
Thank you, Corey. So those are your two Atlas Lloyd College Mountain Top 10 matchups, two really good games. More scores for you. East Ridge takes down Knox Central 30-15, and then Knox Central hanging 50 on South Laurel 50-20. The final, Clay County getting the 26-14 win over Greene County, and then Wayne County blowing out North Laurel at home 43-8, the final there. Well, we've arrived at our halftime break of the show, just about 12 hours away from Kentucky, taking on a top five Georgia Bulldog team at Kroger Field. But first, we continue with our Friday night action, heading back up to Lexington.
Hi, everybody. Dave Baker here for Total Pharmacy Care. In football, the object on Friday nights is to prove your team is better than their team. Well, at Total Pharmacy Care, we prove that every day. Our team of pharmacists only fills prescriptions, no cards or candy or novelty items, just complete focus on explaining and filling your prescriptions. So tell your doctor to choose the team at Total Pharmacy Care. We're located in Phelps, Belfry, Pikeville, Prestonsburg, and Martin. It's not just a name. It's a promise.
Hope here for Walters Nason. As the first female president, I promise to stop high prices. I promise low payments. I promise low financing, but high trade-ins. I know I can keep these promises. All you have to do is shop at Walters Nason.
Get the 2020 Nissan Altima, 0% financing for 72 months, plus $1,500 cash back.
Vote Hope for president of Walters Nissan. I should probably tell my mom I'm running.
Why on earth is Mitch McConnell making false attacks against Brad Barron? After 36 years in Washington, McConnell's scared to be running against a true Kentucky conservative. Brad Barron is a farmer and a businessman, not a career politician. We can trust him to slash government waste and balance the budget. And Barron is 100% pro-Second Amendment, 100% pro-life, and yes, 100% pro-term limits. Vote for the true conservative, Brad Barron, for U.S. Senate. True Kentucky Patriots is responsible for the content of this advertising.
I'm Johnny L. Turner. Thank you for voting for me. My mailer told you who I am. When I was in Frankfort before, I did a job for all the coal miners and all the workers. My son, 98-year-old Aint, and many of my relatives are in the teaching retirement system. There are no road funds for any of these counties. They've got to be voted on next time. All the liberal ads you see are not true. I'm proud to serve you as your senator for the 29th District. Thank you.
Welcome back to our Appalachian Wireless Sports Overtime Show. We head back to Lexington for some Friday night lights. John Hines and Pulaski County Maroons have won six straight and looking for lucky number seven at Tate's Creek. In the first, Commodores back to punt. It's blocked by the Maroons. Jericho Dixon in there for the scoop and score. Pulaski County takes a 7-6 lead. Tate's Creek had the ground game going. Kashawn Doubthit takes the handoff and goes to the far sideline for six. 13-7, Doors back in front. Move ahead to just before the half now, 14-13, Pulaski County. And Tate's Creek having punting problems again. Leighton Abbott recovers the fumble snap for the Maroons, and that sets up an easy one-yard touchdown by Barrick Williams right here, taking it straight into the end zone. Pulaski County rolls to a 42-19 win over Tate's Creek. They are now 7-1 on the season. Next up, Larry French and Middlesbrough making the trip to Martin County to take on the Cardinals in Class 2A action. Pick it up mid-first. Jackets closing in on the goal line, and they would score. Caleb Bogunko finds the red paint from 2 yards out. The Borough strikes first 6-0. My apologies. Martin County would respond, though. Logan Proctor takes the pitch from Jason Maynard, and he finds Pater from 8 yards out. The senior picking up his 7th rushing touchdown of the season. We're tied at 6. Cardinals with it again. They need a couple yards to convert here on 4th down, and they get them, plus a Middlesbrough personal foul would put MC into the red zone. But the Cardinals would get nothing out of this drive. Maynard drops back, he fires, gets picked off by Ethan Barton. Huge stop there by the Jackets, but Martin County's D would hold Middlesbrough as well. Cardinals looking for the lead before the half. They would find success as they call Kobe Sparks' number. 12-6 was the halftime score. However, Middlesbrough would leave Martin County with the victory. 14-12 comeback win final for Larry French's bunch. To Perry Central, Commodores hosting Russell County. Fireworks early 7-0 already. 4th and 3 for Russell County. Colin Darno takes it around the end to the house for six. 14-7 Lakers midway through the first quarter. Perry Central would show life again on this drive. Chance McKenzie rolling out, finds Ty Vincent on the short completion. Vincent gonna take it down, get the first down and some into the red zone, but the Commodores can't get any points. Ensuing drive for Russell County, it's Darnell again, straight up the middle. He takes this one down inside the red zone. Thought he was gonna take it to the house, but gets brought down, good hustle by the Commodore defenders. Lakers knocking on the door again. Next play, who else but Darnell finishing off the drive, 21-7. Lakers at the end of one. They would take down the Commodores, 35-14, the final. Miscues hurt Perry Central in this one. More scores for you. Number 7, Southwestern, squeaking out the 41-35 win over Madison Central. And then Shelby Valley falling on the road to Harrison County, 29-14. More scores. Rockcastle County falling at Lincoln County, 46-24. And Powell County at home falls to Mason County, 42-20. And as we go to break, here is the Mountain Top 10, brought to you all season long by Alice College.
Walter's Mazda Mitsubishi has always been known as the used car superstore. Well, now that they are restocked with inventory, they truly are a superstore. If you have ever tried to trade and been told you're upside down, Walter's can help. They give you thousands more on your trade-in. They will even buy your car or truck, whether you trade it or not. Check the inventory at waltersmm.com. Or better yet, come shop them in Pikeville.
Shop Walter's Mazda Mitsubishi. You'll find out when others won't, Walter's will.
Friends, Howard Keith Hall here. Have you ever noticed how mean, spirited people think that they are special? My opponent, who you know very little about, actually believes that if he says enough mean, nasty, and scandalous things about me, that it makes him entitled to be judged. For the past 28 years, I have served you and been your friend at the same time. With your vote, I will continue to serve you as your next circuit judge, and I will always be your friend.
Paid for by Howard Keith Hall, Dr. Ronald Hall, Treasurer.
Dave Baker here for my friends at Citizens Bank of Kentucky.
And our message is clear. We're here to serve you and fill your needs. All drive-through services remain open during regular business hours. ATMs are available 24/7, and our mobile banking services are available 24/7. Now, if you need additional help or services, give us a call, toll-free, 1-866-462-2265. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
The bank for your life.
I'm Amy McGrath, and you know I was a fighter pilot, but here are some things you may not know. My mom struggled with polio, so good affordable health care is something I'll fight for. I have a family and hate taxes as much as you do, so I'll work to cut them. My husband's a Republican, and we put country before party, and I won't answer to anyone in Washington. That's the stubborn Marine in me. I approve this message because I'll be faithful to God and only answer to you.
Closed captioning presented by Wolf Williams and Reynolds, serving Eastern Kentucky for Social Security and Federal Black Lung.
Welcome back. Time now for tonight's Walter's Will of the Game, presented by Jack Walters at Walter's Mazda Mitsubishi. The Will of the Night honors goes to Pike Central's Matt Anderson, looking to seal the deal. Anderson, showing why he was Player of the Week, takes this one to the house, and that's tonight's Walter's Will of the Game, where others won't. Walter's Will. Time now for our Citizens Bank of Kentucky. Take it to the bank. Play of the night. Tonight's play comes from Somerset. Kay Grundy now at QB. He's rolling, looking, fires. This one picked off by Seth Mills in end zone. Can he go all the way? You think he is gone, avoiding Briar Jumpers, but he's going to trip up at the end. Still, what a play by Mills. That's tonight's Citizens Bank of Kentucky. Take it to the bank. Play of the night. Due to Terry Wilson's wrist injury he sustained against Missouri, we'll see a new man at the helm for Kentucky this Saturday. Joey Gatewood will get his first start in blue and white. Due to the injury, he saw three series against Missouri this past week as well. Here's head coach Mark Stoops on what he's seen from the Auburn transfer.
He's definitely a big, strong guy. He's got a big arm and can make all the throws. He stands strong in the pocket. You never know, I think, with that position until you get put in that situation is how their vision and how they're going to go through their progressions and step up in the pocket and distribute the football down the field. From what I've seen from him so far, I believe that he'll do that.
So Kentucky looking to get back on track tomorrow afternoon. They play host to number 5 Georgia at Kroger Field. Kickoff for this one set for noon on the SEC Network. Kentucky, of course, looking to snap a 10-game losing streak against the Bulldogs. More Saturday action for you. Whitley County versus Hazard. Hazard at home for the first time all year, rededicating their field. Then at the college level, Virginia Tech traveling to Louisville to take on the Cardinals. This one kicks off at 4 p.m. You can watch it on the ACC Network. Of course, we'll have highlights from all of those games and more on tomorrow's Appalachian Wireless Sports Overtime Saturday night show. It's been fun. Thank you for joining us. See you tomorrow.